has completed his MBBS from Tirupak Medical College and MD from Madras Medical College. Presently serving as Deputy Director here in King Institute since 2008 and served in Madras Medical College as Assistant Professor for 9 years and served as a tutor in Chengalpet Medical College for 1 year. With this introduction, I will just call on Adam. Please stay.
Good evening to one and all. We just have the virology update on COVID-19. This is the coronavirus, novel coronavirus for 2019. Coronaviruses are large enveloped RNA viruses. They are the major cause of respiratory disease, especially in winter, and they cause about 15 to 30% of all upper respiratory infections. Next slide. And they come under the order nidovirals. Nido means it is complex. The genome is complex, and nido means nested. So the nested genome of this order contains, and it is divided into three families: coronaviridae, noniviridae, and astriviridae. And astriviridae contains arterivirus, which causes coronaviral infection in mammals. And noniviridae contains Oka virus, which causes infection in invertebrate host. And we are bothered about this coronaviridae, which has a subfamily of coronavirinae and porovirinae. And this coronavirinae, as sir was saying, alpha, beta, gamma, and delta coronaviruses, which cause human infections. And this is the latest classification. The coronaviruses are grouped into group 1, group 2, and group 3. 229E, NL63, and HKU2 cause, first two cause human infections. The second group contains OC43, HKU1, and SARS coronavirus that causes mainly the human infections. And group 3 causes avian infections. This is the structure of the coronavirus. Next slide. They are all enveloped RNA viruses, large RNAs, single, that is unsegmented genome. Previous slide. So it has got surface glycoprotein, which resembles corona, earth crown. That is, when it is seen in the electron microscope, it resembles the corona, that is crown. And this one. And it has got a matrix protein and another protein. It has got a large and segmented RNA genome. It is the largest of the RNA viruses. Next slide. Next slide. So these seven, as sir was saying, these seven viruses are causing human infections. First will be human coronavirus 229E, NL63, HKU1, OC43. Next came the severe acute respiratory distress syndrome coronavirus. Then the Middle East respiratory syndrome virus. Next is the latest epidemic caused by novel coronavirus of 2019, which is named as COVID-19 by WHO. Next. And all viruses enter the cell through certain receptors. And in this case, for COVID-19 and similar to SARS-CoV, it is ACE2 receptor, angiotensin converting enzyme 2 is the receptor for entry into the cell. Next slide. So the viral attachment to the host cells, then viral enters and unfolds. This expression of the complex, replicase transcriptase complex, is unique to this coronavirus, and there will be viral RNA synthesis, assembly, and release of virions. All these steps will be taking place in the cellular cytoplasm. So the virus enters through the receptor, invagination, formation of the vesicle, then fusion, formation of the integral complex, and then the NM and the membrane protein, nucleoprotein, and S protein. All these are synthesized in the endoplasmic reticulum, and this small genomic RNAs cause this. And RNA will also get enters, and formation of endoplasmic reticulum, only after it is complex, they will get, there is virion assembly takes place inside this, and then exocytosis. And this is the second commonest cause of viral common cold. You know, rhinovirus is the first one, influenza, respiratory sensitive virus, parainfluenza and metapneumovirus all cause common cold. And actually, simple coronavirus started in 1930, which caused infections in small mammals and animals. And only in 1960, it caused the flu-like symptoms in humans. And then it was poison. And in 2002-2003, there is re-emerge in southern China and spread throughout the world, causing there is a spread to 29 countries, causing 8,000 cases, and with the case fatality rate of 9.6%. And this, you can see this China has recorded the more number of cases. And the Middle East respiratory syndrome coronavirus started in 2015, and it causes, there is a 1,621 confirmed cases with 584 deaths, and involving 26 countries. But the highest number of both cases and deaths were found only in Saudi Arabia. You can see the red signal. This is the camels, the reservoir host for MERS-CoV, and then the human-to-human transmission. And so let's show you this. This red one is above 10,000 cases. This is called novel coronavirus of 2019. So I was narrating, I also say a few words. There is on December 31st last year, China reported, China alerted WHO that there were no more number of cases, there is pneumonia cases from the city of Wuhan, and the virus was unknown. They were all from this seafood wholesale market, which was shut down subsequently on January 1st. And on January 5th, they tried to identify the virus, and there is excluded SARS virus as a causative agent. Then the process was going on till today, and the next slide. On February 23rd, there is nearly 76 cases and deaths around 2,300. So how do viruses emerge? There is human health and animal health, and there is perfect equilibrium. Actually, when there is 70 to 80% of emerging diseases are thought to be of zoonotic in origin. There is population growth, climatic change, increasing urbanization, consumption of raw or semi-cooked meat, international travel and migration increase the risk of emergence of emergence and spread of respiratory pathogens. So this, we all are aware of this fever, cough and shortness of breath, and symptoms will be, incubation period will be as short as 2 days to 14 days. And transmission mainly through hands, there is more than 80%. There is after touching the infected surfaces like immigration counter, ticket counter, door handles, hand railings of staircases, elevators, and touching the face, eyes, nose without washing hands. And initially it will be airborne, there is less than 20% that Sar was explaining also. And the fecal transmission also they found out. Next slide. This is the indoor droplet, direct and indirect contact, and outdoor droplets and direct contact. And when does the spread happen? They are highly contagious when they are most symptomatic. Actually, we cannot rule out that there is during infection they may not spread, but this is the most possible way of spreading the disease. This is the Wuhan market, and this is the reservoir host for SARS, severe acute respiratory disease syndrome in 2002-03. And we have now technology update. There is every day we can know the number of cases and the fatality rate also. There is a mortality rate can identify with this WHO update program. Software is there. So what is the criteria for lifting the samples? Persons with travel history to Wuhan after 15th of January, whether they are symptomatic or asymptomatic, the samples have to be collected. And And persons with travel history to the rest of China, Hong Kong, Thailand and Singapore with symptoms, now they have included Nepal and Indonesia in this list. And epidemiologically linked case and contacts of positive cases and as per the case definitions by the physician and the health authorities. And how this, it is done in a coordinated fashion. This microbiologist physician with the state surveillance and district surveillance officer, he can contact these people and one from King Institute of Health in charge are coordinating the program only through IDSP. There is IDSP and there is a Directorate of Public Health and Preventive Medicine is coordinating all activities. And these specimen types, nasopharyngeal, oropharyngeal swabs, bronchial belladonna, lavage, endotracheal aspirate, sputum, tissue from biopsy, serum samples, acute and convalescent sera, whole blood, urine, motion are the probable samples. Mainly now the samples, the swabs are taken in viral transport medium and sent in coordination with DPH to the our center, King Institute of Preventive Medicine. And sample vials and viral transport medium, that is viral transport medium with a swab, sterile containers, RDS, the absorbent materials, it should be kept in a secondary container. There is triple layered container, actually we have to send for this. So it can be a pouch or a secondary plastic container. And along with the hot frozen gel packs, it has been kept in an outer container and should be sent to KAPM. And the patient who is collecting or transporting should have proper PPE, not transporting, and who is testing. And the sample is collected, the neck of the sample vial is covered with the paraffin, and absorbent material is also covered with this. And then the primary container is put into a secondary container, even a plastic container or a Ziploc pouch can be used for this. And then that has to be kept in a tertiary container along with the gel packs. And it should be maintained in cold chain. And we should write that there is the request form which can be downloaded from www.thenv.org. The request letter should be kept in a leak-proof Ziploc pouch along with this pack. And the sender's address, contact number, consignee's name, address, and we should write this particle substance category B on the surface of the tertiary container. This is the specimen referral form. Name of the patient, along with the history, the onset of symptoms, travel history, then symptoms, signs, underlying comorbid conditions, hospitalization, any treatment, everything is there. The specimen information, what are the samples to be sent, everything should be filled up. And depending upon the case definition, it has to be sent. And as I told you, the samples, now we are just getting the swabs in viral transport medium. And we should take appropriate infection control measures while collecting the samples. Deliver all specimens by hand whenever possible. We should not use pneumatic tube systems to transport the specimens. And antigen detection is not used now, but that can be done by ELISA and IFA. And electron microscopy is to show the virus from the stool specimen. Pan coronavirus assay and then the PCR for the E gene. Next slide. This is the electron microscopic picture of the coronavirus. Next slide. So first line screening assay is done. This E gene assay is done in King Institute of Preventive Medicine and Research. And the confirmation, this RDRP gene and L gene are done in Pune Apex Center. So isolation is not possible, and nowadays this SARS-CoV was isolated by using virocilline even in our center. And serum antibody ELISA and hemagglutination inhibition tests are available. These proteins, the spike protein, envelope protein, member protein, and nucleocapsid protein are being utilized for the serology. The development of kit is yet to come to India. So prevention and establishment as per DPH, hand washing is the first one, and cleaning and disinfection of surfaces frequently touched by hands. Like there is a laboratory entry on the patients isolation ward entry. And they have cough and sneezing hygiene. There is covering face and cranky while coughing or sneezing or under the elbow when it is not there should be done. And comorbid condition should be under control. As sir was stating, vanakkam instead of shaking hands is the rule. And surveillance of all influenza like illnesses should be there. And stepping up of hospital infection control practices should be carried on. And older people and children under 3 years should not go out of homes to overcrowded areas. Non-vegetarians should eat thoroughly cooked animal food. Uncooked food should not be consumed. And this will prevent all kinds of influenza like illnesses. There is and also severe acute respiratory infections. So hospital preparedness is that we have to train the doctors, nurses, paramedics and housekeeping about this protection devices. And we should have the stock of PPE and disinfectant like surgical spirit, 1% hypochlorite and Lysol. Isolation rooms should be kept ready. Food arrangements for the passengers and should be kept in, sir was showing picture, that is patient should be kept in ventilated rooms. And the PPE body suit with N95 mask, triple head mask, goggles, shoe covers, and the NAPSAC sprayers, sample collection kit should be kept ready. And this is the full body PPE suit. Next slide. And this is sprayers and the surgical spirit. And public health measures, as we were saying, there is influenza like illness and severe acute respiratory illnesses should be checked and active as the case finding should be there. Hand sanitizer should have at least 70% alcohol and make surgical spirit available for sanitation. And clothes and ambulances with 1% hypochlorite solution should be disinfected. And hospitals, clinics, ambulances, we should use 5% Lysol. And public places, you can use 2.5% Lysol. And households and clean places, 1% Lysol is enough. And these are the preventive measures, frequent hand washing, avoid close contact, no spitting, and the touching of face frequently should be avoided, travel restriction, cooking of food and PPE. And this eighth, there is hand washing technique. There is palm to palm. Next, between the fingers should be washed and back of the hands, base of the thumb and back of the fingers, finger length, then the wrist. And all these eight procedures should be carried out after every procedure. And sir was showing this, there is A and B. If you have, this is the CDC guidance, A and B. There is travel to China and symptoms. You have to isolate the patient and give him PPE and then clinically examine and then inform the health authorities and if he is symptomatic, it should be tested for the samples that is taken with the specimens. And if the samples are negative phase, then the physician is the best guide to discharge the patient along with health authorities, instruct the patient and to go home, and home care guidance and isolation guidance should be given. If at home he develops any symptoms or recurrence of fever or anything, again he has to contact the healthcare authorities or the physician. And this is given by DPH, this is the 24 hours control room number. Any symptom, anything, we can contact this number. Thank you for the patient care.
Any questions?
For any major illnesses, we can do the plasma therapy there. Right now, a lot of cases they are doing it there. People who recovered from the illnesses, they are donating it there. They are trying for a people admitted in a critical care unit, not improving with the standard of your respiratory care treatment, whatever treatments you have suggested. They are trying lopinavir interval, they are trying. Oseltamivir, they are trying, some of the cases chloroquine. In spite of there is no response, they are trying, this is a last resort now. But the trial results has not been published so far. Yeah. But they started using it there. Maybe next 10 to 15 days, some early reports may come out there. They are trying it. That's a good note.
Madam, what prevents to have a permanent virology laboratory in Tamil Nadu? Because you
considerable, sir, right.
here.
Consumables are costly, sir. That's you have to have the PCR kit. I think Apollo can afford to have a lab, but the things are costly. The entire PCR and the number of samples, when it is more, so the reagents are costly.
Considering the population of India, what we have in Puri, why can't the government recommend it and have it from the central government, allotment funds for Tamil Nadu, as Southern Indian maybe?
Hey, now VRDL, there is viral research laboratories are coming up in this, in Coimbatore, Vellore, Salem and Tirunelveli, sir. I think slowly they will pick up and they'll be doing for the next epidemic. I think that they will be prepared to have.
How many samples you have tested so far? And how many are positive or indeterminate? And second thing, whether serological test you are doing it or not?
Oh, we are doing only PCR for the laboratory, sir. Serological, the kits are not there.
But you are asking to send the blood also there.
That's what I told. Only the samples are sent nowadays.
You are preserving the blood or not preserving the blood?
Not preserving, sir. It's not being sent now.
How many samples so far tested? How many were indeterminate something there? Because we hear from the
pathologists, indeterminate
only are giving it there.
No, after confirmation, whether it's negative or positive, it is being sent to Pune, sir.
Okay. But so far, how many samples
I should ask Dr. Kaveri.
How many have tested so far?
I'm not aware,
actually.
This is all samples it is kept confidential and it is sent to IDSP for straight away.
So your protocol says you need to send the throat sample, you need to send the samples of urine as a letter.
No, actually the samples are there, but we are required to do this PCR. We don't have the visa kit now.
Similarly for the H1N type, when we send the people to the King Institute to do the test, similarly right now any travelers they want to, we can send it to King Institute without going to the GH or going to the KHC.
We can have the surveillance officer number, sir. So officer, they are guiding.
Because lot of people they are telling, I am coming from Singapore, I am coming from Malaysia. Can I do the test before I go?
Actually, one of my friend, gynecologist who recently came from Newport Delhi, she was asking me whether to come. But it's only when they are symptomatic, they are taking the samples. They are coming and they are going for quarantine and all. I think maybe if you send and inform the surveillance officer, I think.
Maybe, madam, you are not allowed to reveal how many samples are done. I thought of all of you so that you don't create a scare among us. We don't get scared very easily. Thank you very much, madam.
Thank you, sir. Welcome,
Dr. Shami. Please take the certificate.
Please receive the certificate on behalf of members and President Rupani in Nepal. Thank you very much for coming and sharing your knowledge with us.